Welcome to Christ Virtual Church. Do you believe it, everybody? Christmas time is upon us. And I don't know about you, but I am ready to celebrate with joy in my heart. We're going to do your favorite Christmas carols tonight, recorded live in worship. And I have a special 2020 Christmas message for you. I think it's a message that you need to hear in particular during the Christmas time of 2020. So please make yourself comfortable right now. Maybe pour yourself some hot cocoa even. It's going to be a great Christmas celebration. Thanks for sharing this evening with us.
Shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown.
Inside a manger, oh, what a glorious night. Oh, what a glorious night. I hear the angels singing, hallelujah, let the earth receive her King. I know that love has come. Sing it out, Jesus Christ is born. They below in Bethlehem, the King is sleeping. Oh, what a glorious night. Oh, what a glorious night.
Well, let me just say it and say it from my heart. Merry Christmas to each and every one of you once again. I hope that you have just the most joyful, meaningful Christmas of your entire life. And I'm so happy that you're able to join us for this virtual service. I mean, 2020 has been kind of a weird year, wouldn't you say? In fact, maybe 2020 is going to be a weird Christmas too. Maybe you won't be able to get together with as many of your friends and family. Maybe you won't have the big house full of people tomorrow, but that's okay, because you can still make this a great Christmas. And I'll tell you what, if you're going to make this a great Christmas, here's the key. Rejoicing requires rechoicing. That is, making new choices. You're going to have to choose to be happy, even if things aren't perfect. Abraham Lincoln once said, people are as happy as they make up their mind to be. Make up your mind to be happy. When you wake up tomorrow morning, Christmas morning, set your mind moving in the right direction. You may feel a little bit let down. You may feel kind of blah. You may be lying there in bed thinking, oh boy, I'm going to miss having a big crowded house. I'm going to miss traveling this year to see my family at Christmas time. I'm going to miss that great big family dinner. If you make the mistake of dwelling on all that stuff, you're actually preparing yourself to have a lousy day. You're using your faith in the wrong direction. You got to turn that around and say, you know what? This is going to be a great day. It's Christmas Day, and God is going to find a way to bless me. If you're going to be happy, you have to be happy on purpose. When you wake up tomorrow morning, you can't just wait to see what kind of day you're going to have. You have to decide what kind of day you're going to have. What am I saying? Rejoicing requires rechoicing. In fact, here are three choices that will lead to a happy holiday. First of all, choose laughter over complaining. Let's face it, 2020 was a crazy year. 2020 was the year you called the cops on that stranger lurking around your neighborhood, only to discover that it was your next-door neighbor. You didn't recognize her without the hair extensions and the makeup. 2020 was the year that you learned that the 19 in COVID-19 stands for the number of pounds you would gain in quarantine. I mean, you just got to laugh. Here are some things to laugh about in 2020. The new fashion statement, the 2020 Trikini. How about this mask? My dog's new mask really helps with social distancing. Here's a photo of kids returning to school after Corona. Here's one for the married folks. Wife, did I get fat during quarantine? Husband, you weren't really skinny to begin with. Time of death, 11 o'clock p.m. Cause, COVID. One final picture to make you go, I thought it was a nasal swab. Testing in the rear? Hey, you just gotta laugh, right? Choose laughter over complaining. Let's be like the little boy that I heard about that was riding his new bike up and down the street, shouting and laughing and whooping it up. Perched on the handlebars of his bike was the baby Jesus from the town nativity scene. The police stopped him and they said, "Why did you steal the baby Jesus?" The boy said, "I didn't steal him. I'm taking him for a ride. You see, I wanted a brand new bike for Christmas, and I promised Jesus that if he worked the whole thing out for me, he'd be the first one to get a ride." Shouting and laughing and whooping it up, that's joy. The Christmas angel said, "Behold, I bring you good news of great joy." Not tiny joy, not medium joy, great joy. You know, I finally figured it out. My job as your pastor isn't to bring you down. It's to lift you up. And so every single week I bring you good news of great joy. Here's what I'm saying. To make this a happy Christmas, choose laughter over complaining. And a second choice that you can make, choose faith over fear. Do you know in the Christmas story, every time an angel appears, the very first thing he says is, fear not. And you know what else? The Bible says, fear not 365 times. That's one for each day of the year. You know, a lot of people have been living in fear this year. I actually heard a TV news anchor say, you need to be afraid. You need to be afraid right now. Everybody needs to be afraid. Well, the Bible says God does not give a spirit of fear. My wife told me that. I looked it up. She's right. So if you're feeling afraid, that's not coming from God. That's coming from the enemy. I mean, it's all right to be careful. It's good to be smart and safe and sensitive to others. But don't be afraid. God's going to get you through this. God's got your back. God's got a great plan for your life. And God is making all things work together for good in your life. Choose faith over fear. Do you know what the most downloaded Bible verse was in the past year? I mean, the verse sought out and downloaded the very most in the year 2020. Here it is. Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. Choose faith over fear. And that leads to the final choice that you can make. Choose Jesus over everything. Jesus is not just the reason for the season. He is the reason for every season. Just take a quiet moment right now. Wherever you are, maybe you're all alone at your home right now. Maybe you're surrounded by your family, your immediate family. Wherever you are, whatever your day has been like, just get real quiet. Just get real, real quiet in your heart right now. And think about Jesus as a little baby lying in that manger. The eternal Creator came to us as a baby. I mean, the one who is so powerful, he could say, let there be light. And light would come shooting out at a speed of 186,000 miles per second. The one who flung the stars into their places and spun the planets in the black night sky. The one who breathed life into us at the dawn of time. The infinite became an infant. The almighty, transcendent God decided to become a baby with chubby legs, little fingers and toes. And the Bible calls him Emmanuel, which means God with us. And I just want you to know that wherever you are right now, God is with you. God is with all of us right now. And he said, never will I leave you. Never will I forsake you. He said, don't be afraid, for I am with you always. He said, I have come that you might have life and live it to the full. So come to him. Come to him now once again on this Christmas Eve. Whisper the name Jesus in your mind and know that he is there. Would you let me lead you in a simple prayer? Dear Jesus, this Christmas night might be a little bit different, but I've made up my mind to be happy. Rejoicing requires rechoicing, and I'm choosing to have a great Christmas. I choose laughter over complaining. I choose faith over fear. And most of all, I choose you, Jesus. I choose you over everything. You are Emmanuel, God with us, and I know that you're with me right now. I know that one day I will be with you in heaven. Until then, I pray this in your name. Amen. Well, tonight we celebrate the presence of the Child of Bethlehem among us as we share the gift of Holy Communion. Please prepare now for that. If you'd like to just pause this for a moment and go ahead and get some bread or crackers, juice or wine, and prepare to welcome the Child of the Manger into your home, into your heart, and be filled with the wonder and the magic and the joy of this holy night. The same wonder and joy that Mary and Joseph, the shepherds and the angels, felt on that first Christmas so long ago. Let's now prepare. That baby in the manger grew up to be an amazing man, the Lord of life and the defeater of death, the Son of God and the Savior of the world. He loved us, lived with us, showed us the way home. When it was his time to leave, he had a quiet candlelit meal with his closest friends, a last supper. During that supper, he looked them in the eye and he said softly, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Tonight, we honor the Lord Jesus Christ, the eternal Son of God, who became flesh and blood. This is the body of Christ. We celebrate his presence together. In the same way also, he took the cup, and after giving thanks to his Father in heaven, he passed it among them, saying, "Take and drink. This is my blood, the blood of the new covenant, which has been poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of your sins. Do this often in remembrance of me." And especially on this beautiful Christmas Eve night, as we celebrate your birthday, Jesus, we remember you. And we look forward to seeing you again before long. To Jesus. You have now received the body and the blood, the power and the peace of the risen Lord Jesus Christ. Now may he strengthen you and preserve you in the true faith until that magnificent moment when you walk through gates of glory to see your loved ones and to see your God eye to eye and face to face. Amen. And I now invite you to join me in a celebration of light. Maybe you'd like to light your candle even now, wherever you are at home. Maybe there's some darkness right now in your life, shadows of doubt, clouds of discouragement. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." Let Jesus brighten up your life. Let him shine in all those dark corners. I invite you to light your candle now. And when you light your candle, ask Jesus to light up your life. And then please hold your light high so everyone's life can be a little bit brighter. Now let's hear the beautiful carols, and I invite you wherever you are to sing, to smile, to celebrate this special night.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the fall on your knees.
Candlelit faces of your friends. And never forget that because Christ came for you, your eternity will be forever different. Now may the light of our risen Lord's love burn brightly in your heart. May his presence brighten even your worst days and darkest nights. And may his strong, gentle spirit never be extinguished within you. Now look at that person next to you, and would you just say to them tonight, I'm glad I got to share this Christmas with you. Love you, glad we're together. And give them a fist bump, give them a handshake, give them a hug. Wish them a Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Folks, I think it's time for some joy. Joy to the world. Let's sing. Well, thanks so much for joining us tonight on this very special night. And you know, I'm thinking about you right now. I'm thinking about you as we record this. The beautiful people that I love, my family and friends, that I haven't seen some of you for quite a while. And I want you to know that even if I haven't seen you, you're still in my prayers. You're still in my heart. And I appreciate you being here and being a part of my life and a part of our ministry. Our final act of worship tonight is to bring our Christmas gift to Jesus. And you can do that by going to our website, right there on our homepage, the homepage of clcsouthwick.org. You'll find a little giving tab, and you can give your gift. And you know, I want to encourage you to think about giving a special year-end gift or a special Christmas gift. I can tell you what our family does. We've done this for years. We always figure out the biggest gift we give to anybody, and we match it each Christmas with a gift to Jesus. After all, it's his birthday. And then please join us again this weekend as we come together for our next CVC service. And we're going to continue by wrapping up our series, our Christmas series called The Gift. We've been taking a super deep look at the gifts the wise men brought and the meaning of them. And this time, We're going to have some fun as we look at the gift of gold. Remember, he gave frankincense, myrrh, and gold, and we're going to look at that gold and what it signified. So please join us again this weekend, and let's pray that it is going to be a great 2021. See you soon, everybody. Thanks so much. Merry Christmas.